I could still remember what the war has caused to me. A lot of stories are hidden and hidden forever in our country. Stories that would have changed humanity. I wish no one ever see this. Biologically, I was named Mohammed S. Conteh. But when I was young, I liked to fight with my friends a lot. And at that time, the great boxer in America, Tyson, was making name all over the world. So my friends, brothers, and everybody around me accept to call me Tyson because I always win my fights.
Boxing camera.
Ah, busy day. I'm still filming. I'm presently asking the camera person to film me when talking to you, because we are filming before you just call. Well, I think one of the risks is just like the travel risk, maybe. Somebody will think about that.
No, I'll be really want to go tomorrow, but I'll be seeing you today, so for joining you one time.
Okay, let's just come in and take the camera from from this guy hand. This small family. This is now Aisha Conteh. Hey, Soma.
Aisha S. Conteh.
I have a family of five. My mother and four kids of my late brother. They all depend solely and wholly upon me. My family used to live with me here in Makeni. But right now, I have taken them to the village because life has been so difficult with me.
I keep thinking of what's happened with my family and many people that live around me during the war. And if I am here and I am opportune to have this camera with me and with the little knowledge that I have, and I just sit back and watch the whole thing pass by, then I will continue to be like regrets after the Ebola situation, like how I was when the war ended. A guy whose name is John. They were trying to take him to Kenema for Makeni, who jumped from the vehicle. I was there, I present, I witnessed it. But people were asking me that, why do you want to jump? Well, he said he wants to jump to kill himself. People were telling him, no, they are not taking you to kill. He said, they are taking me to kill me. I'm going to be dead if they take me there, because all the people have been taken to this place, I never see anybody come back.
Pretty make you can at the center.
Yeah, I lost. I can at center. I lost me man. I lost me modolo. I lost me three people there. So now me cannot the field right. Now me can come at center. Direct.
Now you come for yourself or now people go take you?
I me come for myself.
So where you want? Wait till they say now you get.
They not tell me nothing. They not test weight.
What if he say now he make you lost your family?
I'm not sure.
You don't know if Ebola kill the people them or not?
Ah.
Nobody no ever tell you anything but you people and I one.
Is this?
Oh, see that? Proud for me. Each of you.
There is this house which, like, 3 people have been killed by Ebola already. Bodies have been taken by the medical doctors for burial. They brought the results positive, but they don't come to quarantine the home. When people started seeing corpses of Ebola, they never saw somebody whose gun like bleeding from the eyes, the nose, the ears, the mouth. And so people have the disbelief that maybe this is something like the government is doing to make money. When it happened, nobody believed. Most people think this is not true because they don't have the idea of the epidemic.
Turn this.
It's like, anyway, the people here, the nurse, not to say no, no, go, no, no, I entertain me, but no, no, protect. So you will able grab, forgot to take this food, now you will leave. So you will not able grab, no. You know, you get a job. So pass to somebody with the inside, we able grab, go and take them food and then go meet one of the food. So me now, now maybe the grab, go and take the food, give the man them, go and able grab.
Things are not like somehow simple, very difficult, no job. All I do now is like just going out filming and come back. And for over a month now, like I was saying, I was like basically surviving from eating curry in the morning and in the evening when I go to bed.
Bag rights. See that? Police personnel. They are on the road. Just know this thing. Just to make sure security tight.
The way it is now to travel. But I I just have to do this.
This is the way her economy goes. If I tell you, say, na say pass, na saw, na say pass, na lie. Me, I just is sick, and if I don't have me host for two. Up to 15 people don't wait, don't die, Isaiah. But I no go know. And if you know to add no more with religion, no able to talk to myself. Because the kind of pain where they feel the big wife, he die, the picking the other one, and na infernal year, this year, na infernal year, Mohammed called killer. No could name them. Come really when they talk Ebola, Ebola, and now we page ban and music na bad sick. You cannot talk to me no more. The one that we don't die inside. Up to 86, 90, 96. Because we don't die. It's Ebola.
Okay, so just get me a tight close-up shot from anybody on most of the signpost the way you can see. Let me able let read the signpost.
Okay, let
I need a tight close-up from signpost to signpost.
Yes, Olenso.
I mean, them people they are there, they do their own job. But we are the grave them even before the person come. Because they're very much sure see then they get people them already.
This leg of many things but we. Then can okay and a sacrifice will sacrifice. Just a voluntary. And we pray to God, let God make government not forget but we. Now they can visit we. We say we tell them a thank you. They at least we are able to talk to the big one there. But really we don't render our service. They do something now, yeah. So that's no more I get to tell you now. Yes, because...
Yeah, well, yeah, fine. You yourself can come and tell me about that.
Can you put them back?
No, wait, let him come.
God, I'm poor. Now, my man, Jebangua, actually, this job here, we are in a risky position. Risky. At least when we can walk here, we go home. With parents here, and they want power. They say, because all they get Ebola. But no way to do, we're there for save the country. If we all keep follow the same way, we need a car, okay, and a problem. I see something that exists in the country. They see Google worst.
Like for somebody like Ibrahim, whose parents are the lepers. The grandmother that he has now is sick and she can't even go to the town to beg. And the grandma has nowhere to turn around. That's one of the reasons that you see anytime I talk about my sister, Ibrahim was there, you know?
Really, I'll not be one for let I talk, but there is no way for that at all. This Ebola don't can cause a big problem towards me now. Just like the war where Ebola cause them problem then again, now we country. where they kill boku people them. And this Ebola itself don't can kill boku people them. Now we country. Especially me who they talk now, so I just don't lost me daddy and I don't lost me auntie with me uncle through this Ebola sick here. I only left with me mama, only no more now. Now me into left right now.
Okay, as you see on the background, the crew they set up. We didn't left now for good try for good shoot. From here we go the Independence Square under the clock tower. And of course after the candle by NPA yes, just for establish Makeni. What I believe that also caused the spread of the disease is like the tradition. This is one of the ways that the disease got spread faster and faster. And that's why I've never seen a family in Sierra Leone which has a single death or single person that is affected in Ebola. Once the family started having a positive, you can have 2, 5, 7, or even wipe out a whole family. Continue to what's happening, adios.
What's happening? Mm-hmm. My mother is sick. My dad. I know what you see.
So, any results come when then?
Yes, the results will come. We should pursue results in the Ebola.
We will die. And then I'm quarantine. No, but anyway, that's where we are.
Thank you.
Agbako.
Hey.
No.
No, someone who is a movie character, the part I did kill him. I can't tell my book tangy. Mamma, clear as number, I'm no affetamo, Jay. My back book tangy, it's over by tea. I'm like a book, I'll boom the answer. A problem.
I interviewed him in the morning, and in the evening, he was taken away by the ambulance, and he's dead already. Throughout the 11 years war in Sierra Leone, schools were never closed completely the whole country. But in the 6, 7, 8 months of Ebola, schools were permanently closed throughout the country. Business, every normal life.
So the village will be the go for go take treatment. Then back say how the doctor where they dey, they the go admit Ebola people there. So then they give we come. So we kaya. That day, my mama and my papa na they sleep. I go pick sawa, I cook soup for my mama. And the give first I say eat. I say then can sick way don't come. So if you no eat, I say you did die. I say I know by then tell me you die. You na too don't suffer. We then come at the hospital, then spray all side, then drive with people the way they inside, past the sick people there, and then left there. So that time there now, when my papa come, he can ask the nurse, he say, how that woman they do, because the nurse, they be relating my mama, the woman when we come at village, my mama they help her for brook, do half thing for her. I didn't tell my papa, he say, my mama don't die. I say, my mama. For that time, my papa be in the hospital. I didn't go to the house, go and cry. I back and cry. My mama died in here. My mama died the 12th of September, Friday. And then Friday in here, all day, Saturday, the team come for Canberra. That very day, they died more than 10 at the hospital.
Every day, the numbers keep going up. Going up every day, you know. Things are getting real bad, man, especially in my area. I mean, things are getting really bad.
The member of our area who lost his mother about 2 weeks ago and he died this morning.
You're not going inside it. Take this background. Watch out. Show these people. I need everything.
Everything, no stop for you.
imagine, when he was sick, the reporter, they did not come to collect him for the hospital. Now he's dead, they came to collect him for burial. They don't do see that now, as the body is taken away, and they will just bury him in the Ebola way, and that's all. Yes, man, it's really a pathetic situation.
Some kind of sadness, headache or something. Mary, she's like, last week I went there, I was wanted to talk to her, but she was not there. Somebody told me she goes. I don't know. It said she's in the red zone, so she will not come out. Have been feeling.
His name is Bishi, who lost his mother about 2 weeks ago, and he died this morning. The people around the area, he's somebody who's like a good boy in the area, so help him. He's a footballer as well, so everybody know him, and everybody like the area. People are crying.
I am highly motivated to seize this opportunity of a situation that is arguably worse than the war.
The rebels, you will see them coming.
Still feeling some kind of
civil war.
Sadness.
You don't know who is bringing it. The people that are close to you can kill it. Your wife can kill it. We are descending upon the weak and poor.
I want to put out a story because I just love the film. And I just sit back and watch the whole thing pass by. Then I will continue to be like regrets after the Ebola situation, like how I was when the war ended. The past month is like we are among death. You can just see somebody today and tomorrow they will tell you it's contracted the virus and it's no more. Even when you walk and think of when you come back to the house, if you are not coming back dead. When you sleep, you wake up and check yourself if you are healthy, because maybe you think I'm going to die
tomorrow.
Whenever my kids come of age, I know family members and neighbors start telling them that I'm not the real father. But I think at that time, if indeed they find out I'm not the biological father, but there are some things that will tell them what kind of struggle I have been going through to get them where they are, how I devoted myself, my life, my everything, just to make them feel like they have a father, they think whatever people tell them will not have like impact in what they feel for me.
All right, man.
Okay, man.
Yeah. I could still remember what the war has caused to me. I don't know what I would do that would make me forget that day. I saw some people running. Some passed me by. Some goes into the bush, shouting. and the rebels have reached the village. And I heard the loud gunshots when I entered into our house. But then I saw the blood coming from my sister. I took her into my arms. They forcefully want to rape her and shot her on her chest. All she could do is open her eyes and watch at me. She really wanted to say something to me. Voice was not coming out anymore. Talk to me. Talk to me. What happened? Who did this to you? Talk to me. No. She did not talk. She opened her mouth. No voice come out. She opened her eyes and closed them again. No reference. Lack of technology. Especially when I watch my sister died right in front of my eyes, right on my arms, right in front of her mother. Would I have been with a camera there? I would have filmed that. I would never want to watch it again, but I would have filmed that for people to see. I would have filmed that for people to learn, for people to know what happened to me, what happened in my country.
Lost, you can still be among death and stand as a living.